Hello and welcome for a new UnityFT Designer video tutorial. My name is Michael and I'm working for Electronic Assembly's development team.
Today's tutorial gives an overview of the object structure in the UnityFT series and the basic options for placing and changing objects with the help of the UnityFT Designer. The focus is on object manipulation such as scaling or shearing, as well as on the alignment of the objects with each other. In addition, functions of the designer explained, which make the work easier. In further tutorials, the individual objects such as buttons or spin boxes will be discussed in more detail. We first start with placing objects from the toolbox by drag and drop. We choose rectangle, polygon, and ellipse. The object properties size, rotation, and shear can be changed graphically. These settings can also be adjusted in the object editor on the right side. Each object is automatically assigned to an object ID. With this ID, the object can also be manipulated with commands via one of the serial interfaces. Double-click on the ID opens the ID editor. Here, all IDs of the objects and screens are summarized. The object ID can also be changed with the editor. For new projects, the check mark is set at unique global object IDs. This means that every new object created by the designer is assigned to a unique ID. If the check mark is not set, the same IDs can be assigned on different screens. If you want to use a screen transition function, a unique object ID is required. Each newly added object is automatically placed in the layer at the top. In the project tree, you can also sort by the layer order. You can adjust the layer order. To do this, open the context menu of the object with the right mouse button. Under the menu item layer, you will find the functions to bring the selected object to the front or to the back. Position of an object results from the coordinate related to the object anchor. Each object has 9 unchangeable anchors. If you select an object, the orange circle determines the current anchor. If you move the mouse over the remaining anchor positions, they will also be highlighted. With a double click, you can change the anchor. This can also be done in the object editor. To simplify the positioning of the objects in the UnityFT Designer, there are some features. They can be found in the ribbon tab Alignment. First, there is a grid. This can also be adjusted in size. If you now move an object, it can only be positioned in a fixed grid. Another function is the Alignment help. Lines are shown as soon as an object is aligned with another. Alignment can also be done directly with the Alignment tool. As an example, I place 3 buttons. Now I select all of them. Then I click on Align Left. All of them are now correctly aligned. The object selected first provides a reference for this. Next, I would like to split the buttons into equal parts. For this, I use a function space vertically. Sometimes it can happen that several objects lie on top of each other, and it's difficult to select them with the mouse. To show this case, I place a text on top of the rectangle. Clicking on this area while holding down the Shift key opens a new dialog. All objects that are located at this position are displayed here. If you want to choose the text, you can now easily select it.
I hope you enjoyed today's UnityFT video tutorial. Maybe you have time and play around a little bit with our sample projects and enjoy our other tutorials.